Good morning, everyone present here. George Bernard Shaw once said, I quote, "There is no love sincerer than the love of food," unquote. All day's work is meant to give us a 3 times peaceful meal. Let's invoke the Lord in thankfulness. I request Tapan sir to sing the prayer song for the virtual assembly. Tapan sir. Theme for the day is grow, nourish, sustain together. We have class 11 children amidst us who readily agreed to present today's assembly. Thank you, children. I request Kalashree of class 11th B to initiate the event with the pledge. Kalashree.
Pledge. India is my country and all Indians are my brothers and sisters. I love my country and I am proud of its rich and varied heritage. I should always strive to be worthy of it. I should respect my parents, teachers, classmates and all elders and treat everyone with courtesy. I shall be kind to animals and plants. To my country and to my people, I pledge my devotion. In their well-being and prosperity alone lies my happiness. Jai Hind.
Good morning, everyone. I am Snehal D'Souza of 11C. Today I am here to share a thought said by Mahatma Gandhiji. There are people in the world so hungry that God cannot appear to them except in the form of bread. I repeat it. There are people in the world so hungry that God cannot appear to them except in the form of bread. Thank you.
Good morning, I'm Ruchana Pandit from class 11C. The secret of success in life is to eat what you like and let the food fight it out inside. I repeat it, the secret of success in life is to eat what you like and let the food fight it out inside, by Mark Twain. Thank you.
Good morning, respected teachers and my dear friends. Food is defined as any substance to provide nutrition to an organism. But we know that it is so much more than that. Food is a representation of a culture. It is a major part of festivals and events. Eating is something we all have in common. Food brings people together. On this special day, October 16th, World Food Day, I would like to introduce you to six words related to food. My first word for you is gastronomy, spelled G-A-S-T-R-O-N-O-M-Y. Gastronomy is the study of the relation between culture and food. It is also defined as the science of good eating. The word gastronomy is derived from the French word gastro, meaning cooking, and nomi, meaning science or study. My second word for you is aerate, spelled A-E-R-A-T-E. To aerate means to add air to any ingredient of the food to make it lighter or increase its volume. It is directly derived from Latin word meaning air. My third word for you is caramelize, spelled C-A-R-A-M-E-L-I-Z-E. Caramelization is the process of browning of sugar. With added time, sugar starts to turn brown. It gives a nutty brown color and a more sweeter flavor. This is especially used in making cakes. This word is derived from the French word caramel, meaning burnt sugar. My fourth word for you is macerate, spelled M-A-C-E-R-A-T-E. Maceration is the process of softening or breaking down of food using liquids. It is also used to put a flavor in the food directly from the liquid. The word macerate is derived from the Latin word macerat, meaning to make soft. My fifth word for you is julienne, spelled J-U-L-I-E-N-N-E. Julienne is a special culinary knife cut in which the ingredients are cut into soft, thin, and long slices. You can observe this in the cutting of carrots. My last word for you is veganism, spelled V-E-G-A-N-I-S-M. Veganism is the practice of abstaining from animal products and disregarding animals as a commodity. This word is directly derived from the English word vegetarian. My classmate will elaborate on this further on in the assembly. Food recently in the lockdown has gone to a whole other level. It has gone online. Under trending hashtags like hashtag cook with me, celebrities, influencers, and other people have taken on to online platforms like YouTube and Instagram to show off their culinary skills and food interests. I encourage you all to check this out in your free time. Thank you.
Hi, Bhuvan.
Meeting you after a long time.
Yeah, really. Corona has locked us inside our houses.
True. Do you remember what's the speciality of today?
Yes, of course. It's 16 October, World Food Day. How can we ever forget it, as it is all about our favorite work, eating.
Missing those days where we would celebrate Food Day every day by sharing food among ourselves in school.
Do you actually know why World Food Day is celebrated?
No, never thought about this before.
World Food Day is celebrated in honor of founding of Food and Agricultural Organization by United Nations in 1945.
Oh, really? I didn't think it is such a big day.
It's okay, man. Being food lovers, it would really be worthwhile if we could know such teeny-weeny details at least. By the way, you know what my all-time favorite is?
Tell me, Aranya, I am all ears.
I tried a lot of dishes during the lockdown, and amongst all of them, Kashmiri biryani is my favorite. It's made without using onions or garlic, but lots of dry fruits are used in it, which makes the dish delicious.
Oh no, you are making my mouth water. I can understand why it's your favorite. It is interesting that our country is a land of varieties. Every state has its own speciality. Think of Andhra Pradesh, spicy avakaya and Mughalai Hyderabadi biryani.
Karnataka, uppittu, bisibele bath, kari kadabu.
And Gujarat, dokla, fafda and shrikhan.
Maharashtra for puran poli and misal pav.
Kolkata for rasgulla and misti dohi.
Bhuvan, when we have the opportunity to taste some of them, we must think of those 182 million who go to bed hungry every day.
You know, Ananya, two-thirds of the entire world doesn't get a healthy one-time meal. Africa is the world's hungriest.
That's true. Poverty, unequal distribution of food, and due to many other reasons, people aren't getting food. But don't you think the government must resolve it?
Ananya, it's not always the government who needs to resolve the problems. We also need to do something to eradicate the problems of hunger. The main motto of World Food Day is also the same. That is to ensure that no one sleeps hungry in the world. But I am confused sometimes as to what can we do in resolving the problems faced by people due to hunger.
What we can't do, Bhuvan? Listen. First, we shouldn't waste food on occasions. Awareness should be created amongst people not to waste food. Second, if any excess food is left out, donate it to the poor instead of wasting it. You know, there are some organizations like Akshaya Patra, vote to provide at least one-time nutritious meal to the underprivileged. Third, eat as much as you need. Don't waste or throw. Can't this be done at your level?
Of course, yes. These steps are too easy. Everyone can follow this.
We end up here wishing you all a thoughtful World Food Day. Enjoy eating. Remember not to waste food. Donate food to the needy.
Want not, waste not. Thank you.
Great, great.
Good morning, everyone present here. I'm Aditi of class 11A, and today I'm going to express my views about veganism. Veganism is the practice of abstaining from the use of animal products, especially in diet, and an associated philosophy that rejects the commodity status of animals. An individual who follows this diet is known as a vegan. The main motto of veganism is to prevent animal abuse and slaughtering. For example, to obtain milk from dairy cattle, a cow is made pregnant to induce lactation and then they are slaughtered. At birth, female calves are separated from the mother within 24 hours and male calves are slaughtered. A mother is separated from its child, which is the most painful thing for a living being. This is the main reason why many people go vegan. A vegan diet consists of seeds, grains, legumes, fruits, vegetables, nuts, and plant-based milk products. Thus, I conclude my speech by saying that go vegan, save the animals, save the environment. Thank you.
Good, Aditi.
Thank you, children. I now request our new vice principal, Sri Sandesh Roy, to speak on the occasion. Sir, please.
Thank you, madam. Respected principal, sir, HM madam, all learned teachers, and dear students. A warm good morning to all of you. I have seen presentation of all the students and I appreciate each and every student has performed well. The conversation between Divakar and Anya, it is very informative and very knowledgeable. And I must say that the girl who explained about the vegan, that is also very relevant. And you know that there are so many that renowned persons, they have become vegan to save the animals. While I was listening to the discussion of the students, I appreciate that the students are now stressing more on our Indian food. And I do appreciate I am the follower of the Indian food. The Indian thali, whether it is North Indian, South Indian, Central Indian, whatever be. They are the best food which consists of all the nutrients. My dear students, I am happy none of the students have discussed about the pizza, burger, which are the only fast food which does not contain any nutrients value. And I hope that students will follow our Indian culture. They will eat Indian food and they will more depend upon the vegetables, food, fruits and grains. They will not be going to eat the fast food which is not good for their health also. I enjoyed the assembly. And this is a good opportunity for me to interact with all of you through virtual assembly. For this, I thanks to Principal Sir, Assembly Coordinator, and overall I must congratulate all the teachers, those who are involved in this activity to make it successful. One thing I would like to say at last. It seems to that the talent of the students are increasing day by day, even they are sitting at the home. This is a very good job being done by the students. Thank you. Have a good day.
Thank you, sir. May I now request our principal, Shri K. Ramachandran, to share his views about the day in general and our assembly in particular. Sir, please.
Good morning, everybody. Actually, I too enjoyed the assembly so much. Because more than ever before is relevant today, especially during the lockdown. As the former speakers beautifully pointed out, so many millions of children and adults are starved in this planet, up there from Africa to down there. So in Australia and Europe, rate of people going hungry is too less as compared to Asia and Africa. And Africa is the origin of mankind and they have natural resources more than all the continents, rest of the continents put together, so much forest wealth, so much river wealth. But unfortunately, the problem comes in the supply chain. Actually, the former speakers have not left me out with any point. They have thoroughly analyzed all the points. But I would like to insist once again on these two things. One is on distribution of food and the other is on wastage. I will stick to that. And as someone pointed out, I think Anugrah, he defined food. And in layman's terms, let me define food as fuel for animal. If there is no fuel, nothing worth its name can take place. If the nutritious food is consumed by any animal, its body, bodily growth, intellectual growth, everything happens. Otherwise, a starved child can get paralysis, can get so many diseases related to blood, insomnia, what else and what not. And I think till the last man goes hungry, we cannot call mankind civilized, even in 2020. So enormous supply is there. I'm sorry, enormous production is there. Enormous demand is also there. But the demand and supply do not meet each other. And that is why the ends do not meet for many, many animals and humans. Is due to improper distribution cycles. The new format proposed by the central government hopefully will take care of this part. Agriculturists will certainly decide to whom to sell, what to sell, when to sell, how to sell, to how much to sell. And when the farmers become rich, the whole process is being taken care of. There will be hiccups initially in the system, which we call as teething problems. But I am sure, at least in India, even now, I don't find starvation deaths when I open up the newspapers. People take care of one another. So many NGOs and individuals are also feeding people around them. So many great things are happening. And this disaster, COVID, is an opportunity in disguise, and many people are going back to introspection. Now the need for food and its importance is felt better than ever before. As a former speaker rightly said, World Food Day, WFD, is a product of the United Nations in 1945, the foundation of Food and Agricultural Organization took place in 1945 and continues till today. And biologically speaking, you take any organ or any system in mankind or in any animal, there is no greater wonder than the digestive system. There is no greater wonder than the buccal cavity. Even more interesting than the nervous system, the central nervous system. I'm not exaggerating. You will understand how the food intake through the mouth reaches various organs and becomes the fuel for people. It's a very interesting phenomenon. And Mrs. Meenakshi said that children very happily, readily agreed to attend the assembly for a public decency or diplomacy or decorum. I can accept that. But I know the frantic activities that were taking place in the past 10 days to contact the children, to persuade them, cajole them, to make this assembly a reality. I will be happy if children volunteer to come forward and take part actively and even narrate some skits, dramas, even dances during special assemblies. My congrats to all the 11 children and all the colleagues who made this assembly. Bhuvan and Ananya's conversation was also highly interesting, informative, and meaningful. And about the coming to the wastage part, see, in the distribution part, if it is okay, the supply and demand will meet each other. There must be a mediator. Mediator can be online channels, can be whatever. And you children, the architects of tomorrow's India, can make this a reality. I am sure you can design so many. In mathematics, you have allocation problems, assignment problems, transportation problems, where, how to reach a particular good to a place of demand is all given with minimal cost to the maximum advantage. It's all, even in circuits in electronics or physics, that talks about this one. You can design a beautiful thing. And why I am talking only about India is, every sixth man in this world is an Indian. We account for almost 1/6 of the world's population. At least if you take care of this country, you can hope Europe has taken care of itself, North America itself, South America also reasonably okay. In Antarctica and all, there is no human or not many animals around. So only Africa will remain. And that also can be taken care of. Mahatma Gandhi started his career from America, Africa. And I am sure nowadays with the digital platforms available around us, from here you can control Africa, Africa can control Australia, and things can become better. And of all donations, there is a saying in Tamil that says that donation of food is the supreme donation. Of course, I can say that there are three great donations. One is that organ donation. Second is Vidya Dan, they say, educating mankind or educating a deprived person. And the third and the greatest of all donations is Annadan. The reason is, even if you feed your enemy, even if he doesn't want to thank you, his stomach will thank you. This is what that saying in Tamil talks about. Even your worst hated enemy will bless you when you give him food. What more, as Mr. Sandesh Kumar Rai, the newly joined VP, rightly pointed out, all this maza, pizza, and all these things were not discussed today. Please keep them away. The basic indigenous Indian types of food of any state will be nutritious, will be damn good. And today's discussion was not about the foodies. We were talking mainly about the greatness of food, because even the Lord says in Bhagavad Gita, when you are feeding people, there is no great form of worship greater than this. Thank you all. Good day. Bye.
Thank you, sir. Let's end the assembly and start our day with a beautiful recital that we would have all done as kids in kindergarten. Thank you, Lord, for the world so sweet. Thank you, Lord, for the food we eat. Thank you, Lord, for the birds that sing. Thank you, Lord, for everything. Thank you, everybody, for being here, and have a wonderful day ahead.